Okay, let's talk a little bit more about that test set training set methodology. Now, what will happen if we only have one data set to work with? For example, we've got one big draw from our hidden distribution. Well, one thing we can do is we can divide that large data set into two smaller sets and use one for training and one for test. We need to keep them separate. It's also probably important to make sure that we do randomization before we do that splitting so that we don't, say, by accident, end up with all of the winter data in our training data and all the summer data in our test data. That would be bad. Now, how large should we make our different splits? Well, these are two things in tension. The larger we make our training set, the better model we're going to be able to learn. The larger we make our test set, the better we'll be able to have confidence in our evaluation metrics. We'll have tighter confidence intervals. If we have a very large data set, things are good. If we've got a billion examples, we might be able to still hold out 10 or 15% for a test and have strong confidence intervals there. If we have a very small data set, then we might need to do something a little bit more sophisticated, like cross-validation. Now, there is one classic gotcha that's worth bringing up, and this is that you do not ever want to train on your test data. This will give you unrealistically strong opinions about how good your model is. In particular, if you ever find yourself on that magic day when you have 100% accuracy on your test data, double check that you have not made a mistake and have accidentally trained on your test data. This can happen. It happens to everybody at one point or another. So before you celebrate and throw a party, double check your data.